Hello, my name is Natalie, and I'm one of the engineers that works on Google Web Designer. And in this video, we're going to take a look at the CSS panel and how it works and what you can do with it. So when you edit an element's appearance or position and layout in Google Web Designer, those changes end up as CSS, which the tool automatically generates for you. So for example, when I draw a simple div, if we go to code view, we can see the element here in the HTML, and the CSS style rule that was automatically applied to it via this CSS class name. And then if in design view, we, for example, give it a background color, then we can see that in code view, this color change was set as the background color CSS property on this elements class. So as you make changes and edit your elements, Google Web Designer will automatically make a lot of decisions for you under the hood regarding what CSS to create and where to put it. And this can be really powerful, but sometimes you want a little bit more control than that. Of course, you can always go into code view, but as your file gets larger, hunting for the right rules can be pretty difficult. So this is where the CSS panel comes in. The CSS panel is a CSS inspector and editor tool. And if you've ever used a tool like Google Chrome's developer tools, the styles panel, this is very similar, same idea. At any given point, the CSS panel is showing you all the style rules that apply to the element in order of precedence, maximum to lowest precedent. One at the top is special. This actually refers to the inline style declaration, so the style attribute on the element. And the rest are just style rules. And so whether you want to edit these style rules directly or whether you want to have more fine-grained control over the hierarchy of your CSS rules, the CSS panel can be very helpful. So let me delete this element and let's walk through a use case. Let's say I'd like to create a button. And what's more, it'll be one of potentially multiple buttons that I'd like to create in my document. And I'd like them all to be within the same visual language. So let's say I have some style guide that I'm following and it presents a specification for all the buttons. Let's say they all have to have rounded corners and a shadow and so on. And so I'd like to mirror that and create a hierarchy of styles. And I can do all of this with the CSS panel without ever having to go into code view. So I have a div drawn here in the shape of a button. And I'd like to create a generic button class, which will hold all the styles that should apply to all the buttons on my page. So I'm going to click this add rule button. Let me call it base button. And let's give it some common button properties. I might have a box shadow. Let's say I want it to be translucent black. And let's say I'd like it to have rounded corners. And you can see that the CSS panel automatically suggests standard CSS properties for me, and I can use the up and down keys to swipe through them. In this case, I want border radius. I can hit tab to accept. And then let's say 20 pixels. The cursor should always be a pointer. And let's give it some kind of background color just so we have something to look at. So just a generic gray button. So now let me define a couple of more specific buttons. Let's say I'd like to have an OK button and a delete button. And they should inherit this base button style, but also have more specific styles on top of it. So I'm going to select both of these new divs, click the add rule button again. And this time I would like to, rather than creating a new style, I want to apply our existing base button class. I'm just going to type that selector in and all the styles for that declaration will get automatically pulled in. And now I can just style each button one at a time with just the styles that should apply to that particular button on top of this base style. So once again, add rule, let's call this one the OK button. And the only thing that I want to be different about this button is that I want the background to be green. And then for the delete button, same idea, but the background should be, let's say, maroon. Much like in Chrome's developer tools, you can debug your CSS by using these blue checkboxes to temporarily turn off certain properties as though they were never defined. This can be helpful when you have a complex system of CSS rules and you want to see what your element looks like without certain style in play. So if I uncheck this background green, we can see this element as though only the base style and the other position properties apply. And if I'd like to take a look at all my buttons, say, without the border radius, I can toggle that on and off. So to recap, we've seen how we can use the CSS panel not only to directly edit styles, but how to create an extensible system of style classes, all without ever having to go into code view. That's it for this tutorial. Thanks for watching.